Hello Harpers, welcome back to Tune Tutor. I'm Tiffany Schaefer. If you have just started playing the harp, then this is the video for you because we're going to learn a very easy to play, easy to recognize tune on the harp, and I'm going to teach it to you piece by piece. So if you've just started out on your harp journey and you've only maybe learned to use a couple fingers at a time, this is the perfect song for you. You won't need sheet music for it, but if you do like to have sheet music and you're learning how to read it, I do have that for you. It is in the description. Click show more. You can get it off my website or through a subscription on Patreon. So check that out. There are two ways to get it. I also have a later beginner version that I'm also going to teach you in this video how to play the right hand using four fingers. And the sheet music, if you get it, will have both versions in there. It'll have the very, very beginner version with a very simple left hand, which I'll show you in this video as well. And the late beginner version will be there as well in the same download. The late beginner version has a slightly more complicated left hand, which you can also find a video lesson for on my Patreon page, so check below for that. I do also have an intermediate or advanced intermediate arrangement of this tune that's also going to be available, but that's another video. Let's tune our harps. Let's make sure everything is in the key of C. Everything is natural. If you tune your harp in C, then you won't need to have any levers up. If you do tune your harp like many people in E flat, then you will need to put up the B's, the E's, and the A's, and then you'll be in the key of C. The tune is a traditional Irish one called Brian Boru's March, and I'm going to play for you now the very beginner one and the late beginner one so you can hear what they both sound like. Then after I play the late beginner version of this, we're going to learn how to play the melody just by watching and listening. And by the way, both of these arrangements can be played on a harpsichord-sized lap harp with no levers at all. The first one, the very beginner one, can even be played on a smaller harp such as a 19 string. Thank you. right, here's how to play Brian Boru's March with only your two fingers. So a couple of things to think about. When you are playing with fingers one and two, we're not going to stick them out like this and keep the other ones curled in. Instead, we're going to try and keep all fingers together sort of as a single unit. Just like this. They're all going to open and close at the same time, and the thumb is going to close just like this, right on top of the second knuckle. So your first placement is going to be the E. This is the E, two E's above middle C. So find whatever size harp you have, find middle C, that's going to be your anchor. And we're going to go an octave above that, and then two more strings above that. Your second finger is going to be placed on that C, above middle C. So your first position is going to look like this. And we're simply going to play. Make sure you have both fingers on the strings before you start. Don't just start with one, but start with two. And we're going to play. And then we're going to go to the next position. It's just the E and the C. And your next position is going to be this B and this A. Then we have two A's. So this is the first phrase. Let's play it again. Look on the harp and realize the two different positions you're using. You're placing two fingers with one string in the middle that you're not touching. And then next, you're placing two strings right next to each other, right below that C. So get used to what both of those look like. And try going back and forth. Now, something that can make this a little bit easier to not get lost, if you have talked with your teacher yet about crossing over or overlapping brackets, you can try that. And that would look like this. That's the act of bringing a finger over. We're going to bring, in this case, the thumb over to the next position before we even play the second string. And bring your second finger over before you played the thumb. So I'll just do that once more, and it looks like this. Great. So whichever way you want to do it, this way is fine too, two separate placings. So we're just going to play this phrase twice. After that, we're going to do the exact same shapes on the harp in a different spot. This time, we have the same shape, a string in the middle we're not touching. This time, it's the red C that we're not touching. And our thumb is on D, and our second finger's on B. And then after that, we're going to move to, again, one string below where your second finger was, and then the string right next to that. So A and G. These two, that's your next two positions. And we're going to play it the same timing, the same way. Then we're going to do it again. All right, so let's play together what we've learned so far. One, two, three, one, two, three. You'll be happy to know the next part is just the same as the first. Thumb on E, second on C. Now we just have one more phrase to learn. Now this is easiest if we do that same crossing over, crossing under thing. We're going to start a whole third down from where we were. So remember we started with our thumb on E, second on C, and then the next first position was down here, one string down. This one is going to be even one string down from that. Your thumb's going to be on C, your second's going to be on A. We're going to play our second first, this time we're going up, before you play C, go ahead and put your second on D. And then before you play D, put your second on E. Put your first on E. So it looks just like this. It'll be even more helpful if you can put your second finger back on D before you play that final E. Then we're just going to go straight down another D, another C, and three more A's. I'm going to play that final phrase. A little slower. If you're not quite getting the brackets yet and the overlapping brackets, let's try it this way. And then bring these two up. Then you can bring these two, D and C. All right, let's learn the B part. That's the whole A part. We're gonna start in a new position that we haven't done yet, and this time our second finger is gonna be on G. Your thumb is gonna be two strings away on C. So we've got two unused strings in the middle. And we're just gonna play two, and then before we play that C, we're gonna bring two up here to D. And then before we play D, put it up on E. Here's how that looks slower. Okay, now, before you play that E, go ahead and put your second finger back on D. And we're just gonna switch like that, back and forth. A few times. Okay, so here's what it looks like again from that G. E, D, E, D, E, D. The E's are always longer. E, D, E, D, E, D. So those E's are always longer, twice as long as the D. Now we're going to do that same position in just a slightly different strings. So, we're going to start on G this time again, and this time your thumb's not going to be on C, it's going to be on B. Before you play B, bring your second to the C. And then before you play C, bring it up to the D. We're going to switch. So listen to that phrase again. D. Oh, this time we're playing B. That's where we're ending. We're not going to end straight on a C. We're going to go one more string down and end on a B. One more time for that phrase. Now we have a very similar phrase as we did in the beginning. That's very close. The only difference now is we don't start on a G, we're starting on an A. So again, A and thumb is on C, we're gonna go up. Then to D and E. And again, long, short, long, short, long, short. Now we have one more phrase to learn. That's the same ending that we already learned before for the A part. So again, it's A and C. Second finger on A, thumb on C. where you play C, come here to the D, E. Before you play D, just go back down to that C. Skip the B. Let's play the A and the B parts together. Normally you'd play the A part twice and the B part twice, but we'll just play each of them once for time's sake. One, oh, and I should let you know, this begins on a pickup. So the timing is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The first note is gonna start on that 6. So I'm gonna count us in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here's the B part. We're going to start again. Four strings apart. Four strings encompassing our fingers. G and C. Now G and B. D, B. Now A and C. Same ending, A and C. Here's how you play the left hand with it. We're just going to play a single A. We're going to do that twice. We're going to move down to two Gs. Come back up to two As. Then we're just going to play A, G, A. So that's all for now. It comes just like this. Oh, and we're only going to play that left hand note with our second finger, and all the fingers are going to go along with it. And the thumb's going to move, even though we're not using the thumb. So when you start, as soon as you play that second finger the first time, this second finger is also going to play. So second fingers together. And again, same thing. Same thing here. Put your finger on G. Same thing as before. Now, here's a slightly trickier part. These A's are going to be together as we come up. And then that G will come on this E. Right like that. One more A with the C. So that, again, sounds like this. A's together. G and E. A and C. Here's the B part, left. We're gonna do this middle C twice. We're gonna do B twice, just below it. And then we're gonna do A twice. Then it's the same part you already know. A, G, A. So here it is. We're gonna start with C, and that's gonna come on G in the right hand. And then again on that E. So let me back up. We're going to do the first notes together. That E's by itself. That E has a C. Sort of in the middle. Let's try it again. Not now. now. Okay, so here's the next part. We have B on the same note, same starting note, second fingers together. And again, it's going to come on that second D. Let's try it again. B and G together. This is by itself. This one has a B. And that's the one where we end on B. Now we're going to back up. Go to A. We're going to do A's together this time. So again, it comes right in the middle there. A, that's by itself, here. And same ending. G with an E. So don't worry about playing the left hand with the right hand right away. Learn the right hand really solidly first, and then you can try putting in the left hand. Or you could try learning a whole line of the melody first before you attempt putting in the left hand. I'm going to show you really quick how to play this, maybe if you're a later beginner and you've already learned how to use all four fingers and you don't know this tune yet. Here's a fingering I suggest. Let's try all four lined up like this, your first fingers on E, then you're gonna go your second finger on C, third on B, and fourth on A. And then that second A can be taken with your second finger. Replace all. Same thing here for the G section, where we have G, A, B, D. And same thing here. Couple ways you could do this next one. It is pretty easy to do 2-1-2-1, 2-3-4-2-2, or you could try just stacking all these up. It's sort of the opposite shape as we had before. It's A, skip the B, and then you have these three stacked. Either way, don't play that E until you've got at least these two fingers back on C and D. They anchor you and get you ready to go to the next part. So let's go on to the B part if you're a beginner and you use all four fingers. You could try. Same way we did it before. 2-1-2-1, 2-1-2-1, and I have us for the late beginner version going down there. Back down to DC. For this part, I think it's pretty easy to do that same shape we had before. Four, skip the A, and then you have three stacked. And they're all there. Same thing, you can come down CB, it's a little extra. Now, let's try again going A, skip, and then three stacked. And you again can come down DC. And then here's the end. So that same shape again. A, skip the B, three stacked. Back down. And there you go. Thank you so much for learning this with me. Be sure and leave a comment below if you enjoyed it and you want to see more very simple tunes like this for beginners. Check out these videos over here if you want to see some harp topics or some more tutorials. Click on my face to subscribe so you don't miss next week's video. Click on the Patreon logo up there if you want to see ways to get sheet music, extra tutorials, and all kinds of fun stuff. I'll see you next time. Bye!